गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, अगेन वी आर बैक टू आवर कोर्स पावर जनरेशन इकोनॉमिक्स EE704C एंड वी आर प्रेजेंटली डिस्कसिंग इन मॉड्यूल 1. दिस इज आवर लेक्चर नंबर 3 एंड वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द लोड फैक्टर्स, लोड कर्व्स, डिमांड फैक्टर्स, यूटिलाइजेशन फैक्टर्स, plant capacity factors, and how to we have learned these definitions and how to reciprocate them in the actual system. So that is our main objective, to study all these terms and how we will be implementing and what are the results coming out from the learning these definitions. So while learning these definitions, let us solve some practical day-to-day life problems so that our understanding, our concept will be more clear. So one question is like this. Question number one is like this. A generating station has a maximum demand. So the maximum demand has been given as this one. So what is the maximum demand for the generating station? Has a maximum demand of 35 megawatts. So the generating station is supplying power for the maximum demand. The demand has been given as 35 megawatts, and the connected load, and the connected load has been given as 60 megawatts. So the connected load has been given as 60 megawatts. The annual generation of units, so yearly annual, so these are the data given, annual generation of units. So what are the is the annual generation of the units? It is given 24 into 10 to the power 7 kilowatt hour. So the annual generation, so the power times the time period, so that comes about annual. So annual means how many hours? 365 into 24 hours. So what is the generation of the total generation of the units into 365 into 24? That comes about 24. So these are the data provided to you. So the maximum demand, the connected load in the system, the annual generation of the units has been given. So we have to calculate the two things. What is my load factor and what is my demand factor? So you are aware of the formulas. So so average load, first of all, we have to find out the average load. So what is the average load? The average load will come about the total generation, that is 24 into 10 to the power 7 divided by 365 into 24 hours. So this is hours and this is in kilowatt hours. So you can understand this. So what is the average load? Load average. So the total generation divided by the hours. So that comes about. It is coming about 27.39 megawatt. 27.39 megawatt. In kilowatt, if we divide by 1000, we will be getting 27.39 megawatts. Now, what is the load factor? We know that the load factor is equal to the average load by maximum demand. Average load by maximum demand. This is the formula. The load factor is given by the average load by the maximum demand. So what is the average load? 27.39 by, now what is the maximum demand? It is given as 35 megawatt. So load factor, so this is in megawatt, this is also in megawatt. So this is a pure fraction. So it comes about 0.78. So load factor comes about 0.78. Now what is the demand factor? How to calculate the demand factor? So it is the maximum demand by the connected load. By the connected load. So the demand factor comes about this formula. The maximum demand by the connected load. Now what is the maximum demand? Again, the maximum demand, we know that it is 35, and what is the connected load? 60. So that comes about 0.58. So we have calculated the load factor and demand factor by using the formula. The load factor is average load by maximum demand, and the demand factor is maximum demand by the connected load. So what is the ultimate thing you have learned from this? Load factor and demand factor are always less than 1. So it is average by maximum, and that is demand factor is maximum by connected load. So these are the terms you have to remember, and you have to use these formulas to get the answer. So the first one is over. Now let us do another one. So what are the data given to you? Number two. So a question has been given. A generating station supplies 4 feeders with maximum demands of. So the 4 feeders are there. 4 feeders. So these are the 4 feeders. 4 feeders. So the what are the maximum demands? So the maximum demands, the generating station supply through the 4 feeders of the maximum demand of 16, 10, 12 and 7. So the maximum demands are 16 megawatt, then it is 10 megawatt, then it is 12 megawatt and it is 7 megawatt. So it supplies, the generating station supplies through the 4 feeder. This is the symbol for the generating station. It is supplying through the 4 feeders. So the maximum demand for each feeder has been given as 16 megawatt, 10 megawatt, 12 megawatt and 7 megawatt. The overall, the maximum demand. Now the second part has been given, the maximum demand has been given as 20 megawatt. 20 megawatt. And the load factor has been also given as 45%. That is 0.45. Load factor has been given. So you have to calculate the another term, that is the diversity factor. You have to calculate the diversity factor and the number of units. So total units generated. So you have to, from these data, you have to calculate the how much units is generated in kilowatt hour. So these are the diversity factor and units. So one part is diversity factor, another part is number total units generated in kilowatt hour. So it is being supplied, is the maximum demand has been given. So we know that the what is the sum of the maximum demands. So the solution will come like this: sum of the maximum demands. So sum of the maximum demands will come about, it is 16 plus 10 plus 6, will come about 16 plus 10 plus 12 plus 7. So this will come about this much megawatt. So this much megawatt, it will come about 45 megawatts. It is coming about 45 megawatts. Now, what is the diversity factor? As per the formula, the diversity factor is sum of the maximum demands, sum of the maximum demands some of the maximum demands by the maximum demand. Simultaneous maximum demand. So, what is the sum of the maximum demands? It is 45. And what is the maximum demand? The maximum demand is 20. At that time, what is the maximum demand? So, the sum of the maximum demands is 45 by the maximum demand. So, here we will be getting it is 2.25. So, it is also a, it has no units, the factor has no units. So, it is a pure number, 2.25. Now the second part, the average demand or average load is equal to the maximum demand into load factor. Maximum demand into load factor. Now, what is load factor? It is average by maximum. So, load factor is average by maximum. So, average is equal to maximum demand by into load factor. Now, what is the maximum demand? The maximum demand is 20 into load factor. What is the load factor? Load factor is 0.45. So, it comes about 9 megawatt. So, the average load is 9 megawatts. So, units generated. So, what will be the units generated? So, units generated will be 9 into 24 into 365. So, 24 into 365 is 8760 hours. 365 days into 24 hours into 9 megawatt. So, what is this answer? So, this comes about 78840 megawatt hour. So, it's simply you have to multiply with 9 with 8760. So, units generated annually. So, this is the most important part, annually. So, annually means how much? 365 days into 24 hours. So, 9 megawatt is average load. So, this much is the units generated annually. So, what is the thing you have learned? The diversity factor, the diversity factor is the sum of the individual maximum demands by the maximum demand on the system. Sum of the maximum demands by maximum demand on the system. So, maximum demand on the system is 20 megawatts. That is the simultaneous maximum demand. So, you have understood this problem. So, let us do number 3. Number 3 problem. So, what has been given? The yearly load duration curve of a power plant is a straight line. So, the yearly load curve has been given like this. It is a straight line. It is a straight line like this. And it has been given, this point is C and this is yearly. So, this is the time axis. So, this one is 0 hours and after 1 year, that means after this is in hours. This is in hours. So, after 1 year, this is the 1 year. 8760 means what? We always remember it is 24 into 365 days. 24 hours into 3. So, that comes about 87. So, from the 0 hour to the 87, it has been given like this. And this point is marked as A and this point is marked as B. So, it has been given B is 20 megawatt. 20 megawatt and A is given as 30 megawatt. A has been given as 30 megawatt. Okay, so what has been given? The yearly load duration curve of a power plant is a straight line. So this is the yearly. From the 0 hour, it is 30 megawatt. So after it is a straight line. So after a 1 year, that is 8760 hours, it has come to the 20 megawatts. So 30 megawatts. So it is a straight line. The maximum load is 30. So the maximum load is how much? It has been given. It has been given as 30 megawatt. And the minimum load is given as how much? Minimum load has been given as 20 megawatt. So the capacity of the plant. Now another term that has been given, the capacity. The capacity of the plant. The capacity of the plant has been given as 35 megawatt. 35 megawatt. So you have to calculate the plant capacity factor. Plant capacity factor, number one. Number two, you have to calculate load factor. And number three, you have to calculate the utilization factor. Utilization factor. You have to calculate all these terms, the utilization factor. So how to calculate? So first of all, the units generated per year. In a year, so how much is the unit generated? So the area of this one, isn't it? The area of this one, A, O, this point and this point, A, C, O, this one. So this one, let us term is as D. Okay, so A, C, D, O. So this one, so units generated, solution, units generated, you can say, units generated. So what will be the units generated? Total area of this curve. So it is obviously, I think you can calculate this area, that it is 8760 into 20 plus half into 10. Half into 10. I think this is a trapezium. This is a trapezium. So half into height into some of the parallel sides. So what is the height? So this one trapezium, half into height. Height is 8760 into some of the parallel sides. So what is this side? 30. And what is this side? 20. 50. So this comes about 2 into 25. 8760 into 25. So that thing, obviously here also it comes 5 to 8760 into 25. So that comes about 219000 megawatt hour. So units generated you have calculated. So now what is the average load? Obviously the average, what is the average? How do we calculate the average? The total units generated, 219000 divided by this is in megawatt hour and by 8760 hours. So this one is the average. So total by total time. So this one total strength by total number of things. So we calculate the average in the simplest form. The average is 219000 divided by 8760. That comes about 25 megawatts. So we have calculated the average load. Now what will be the load factor? Obviously the first one, the second one, the load factor. The load factor will be the average by maximum. Average load by maximum. Maximum load. Average load by maximum load. Now what is the average load? 25. Now, what is the maximum load? I think it is 30. So, it comes about 0.0833. Okay. Now, let me rub. Now, the same question. Other parts, let us calculate. What will be the plant capacity factor? Plant capacity factor. Now, what is plant capacity factor? It is average load by the rated plant capacity. So, what is the rated plant capacity? Rated plant capacity. So, what is the average load? Just now we have calculated 25. Now, what is the rated plant capacity? The rated plant capacity has been given as 35. So, the plant capacity factor comes about 0.714. These are all perfect numbers. So, it has no unit factors because as these are terms as factors, so these have no unit. Now, what is the utilization factor? So, utilization factor is defined as the maximum demand by the rated capacity. Maximum demand by the rated capacity. By the rated capacity. Now, what is the maximum demand? The maximum demand, I think from the figure, you are able to know that it is 30 megawatts. Now, what is the rated capacity? Just now we have seen it is the rated capacity is 35. So, 30 by 35 is 0.857. So, that comes about the utilization factor. So, the thing is that you have to be very much familiar with the formulas. The plant capacity factor, utilization factor, average load, load factor, demand factor, all these terms you have to be very much. So, if you practice a little bit with these formulas, so, you can do any sort of problems. Let me rub. So, let us do another one. Question number four. So, it has been asked like this. Calculate the total energy generated. So, we have to calculate the total energy generated. You have to calculate total energy, how much will be the total energy generated if the maximum demand. What is given? The given is the maximum demand. The maximum demand is how much? It has been given, it is 120 megawatt, and the load factor has been given as how much? The load factor has been given, it is 50%. So, how to calculate the first of all, how the load factor is defined? The load factor is equal to energy generated. In another way, it is been represented energy generated per annum by maximum demand into hours in a year. So, how many hours in a year? So, you can write like this. So, the energy generated per annum is, so the maximum demand is how much? 120 megawatt. Megawatt, you can convert it into kilowatt. So, this much kilowatt, 120 into 10 to the power 3 this much kilowatt. So this much kilowatt into the load factor, into the load factor, the maximum demand into the load factor. What is the load factor? Load factor is 0.5. And what is the number of hours? Hours is nothing but 24 into 365. So this many energy will be generated. So energy generated per annum divided by maximum demand by the hours in a year. So simply you multiply, you will be getting 525.6 into 10 to the power 6 kilowatt hour. Okay, so let me rub this one. Let us do another one. Here it has been asked, question number 5. It has been asked the demand factor. You have to calculate the demand factor as well as you have to calculate the load factor. You have to calculate the demand factor and the load factor of a generating station. The connected load is given. The connected load. So how much the connected load has been given? As 50 megawatt, and the maximum demand of, utilize the formulas always. You have to be, formula should be in your mouth kit, and the maximum demand is 25 megawatt, and the units generated. So units generated, that is also data given. Units generated is also given. These are the given. These are the given data. You have to calculate this one. Diversity factor and load factor. So units generated has been given as 40 into 10 to the power 6. 40 into 10 to the power 6 per annum. Yearly. Per annum. So these are the data given to you. So first of all, demand factor. This is demand factor, not diversity factor. Demand factor. Now, the demand factor is maximum demand by the connected load. Maximum demand by connected load. Connected load. So, the maximum demand is how much? 25. And the connected load is 50. So, the demand factor is 0.5. So the load factor, how to calculate the load factor? Load factor is the average demand by maximum demand. The average demand by the maximum demand. Now, how to calculate the average demand? The average demand is units generated, that is 40 into 10 to the power 6 divided by 8760. This is our average. And what is the maximum? That is 25. So just you simply calculate, you will be getting 18.26%, that is 0.1826. So till now the problems we have discussed. So we will be discussing continuation with these sort of problems in the next class. So go through these problems, understand the formulas and memorize the formulas so that it will be useful for your understanding. Thank you, students.